Half a million trucks are registered to drive on Australia's roads. Many travel huge distances between cities to deliver their goods. For drivers, the work can be tiring, repetitive, and boring, until something bad happens. Luckily, no one was killed in this crash.
Trucking is Australia's deadliest job, with drivers 15 times more likely to die than workers in any other industry. Poorly maintained trucks, driver fatigue, and drug abuse are some of the factors behind these statistics. Australian authorities are stepping up their efforts to cut the debt toll.
Here at the Mount White Heavy Vehicle Safety Station in New South Wales, officials direct trucks off the highway into special lanes to check for defects.
These spot checks use sophisticated screening technology to catch rogue operators. Over the past 5 years, more than 1,000 Australians have died in crashes involving heavy vehicles. Other developed countries suffer a similar proportion of fatalities, while the carnage in developing countries such as South Africa is much higher.
So some of the basic things we find, tyres that are bald or below the limit, oil leaks, fuel leaks through two brakes not working.
Within minutes of my arrival at the safety station, the inspectors pull over a truck with a faulty trailer connector and issue a defect notice to the driver. A few minutes later, a second truck is pulled over with a potentially serious safety issue.
What we find is a loose piece of what looks like granite, very hard rock, sitting on the tray here, ready to bounce off and go through some unsuspecting driver's windscreen and hit him in the face.
Some of the worst defects are found in vehicles owned by smaller operators or in owner-operator trucks rather than large road haulage firms. But in a hyper-competitive freight industry, many of the larger companies subcontract to small operators to cut costs.
Unfortunately, sometimes the contracts that people enter into don't provide for the safety and compliance.
Tougher enforcement is one part of Australia's response to truck safety. Regulators are also introducing minimum pay for drivers and updating chain of responsibility legislation, which aims to make all parts of the supply chain using freight answerable for the safety of trucks. The commercial risks for operators which break road safety rules and become involved in crashes are considerable. The risks for other drivers on the roads can be devastating and in some cases fatal.
Enforcement actions like this one in New South Wales are having an impact on behaviour in the freight industry. But with freight volumes set to double over the next 20 years and cost pressures a constant concern, road safety campaigners say more needs to be done to save lives. Jamie Smith, Financial Times, New South Wales.